What is machine learning? When one comes across the word learn, the first thought that crosses the mind is the ability to observe, understand, and draw inferences from any news, event, situation, or activity and store it mentally and use it to resolve problems arising out of similar situations or experiences. For instance, when learning to drive, one is taught the basic functions and usage of accelerator, clutch, and brake, and as one starts driving, one begins to learn when to use which of the three, either alone or in combination. So as one comes across situations such as, say, traffic jams, then one applies the learning that has been mentally noted in the past to navigate smoothly through a traffic jam. In due course of time, as one starts to gain expertise, one becomes adept at applying learning when confronted with situations. This process of drawing from previous experience and mapping it to present scenario and deciding the action to be taken happens in fraction of seconds. This whole process happens inadvertently and is called learning. When talked about in terms of machine, machine learning is the process of developing a computer system in such a way that the machine is trained to observe, understand, and draw inferences of different situations and events, and automatically learn to apply the understanding when confronted with similar experiences. For this learning, the machine, which is nothing but the computer system, is programmed to observe and store trends and patterns in data, identify and store the events when the data changed. This way, the machine learns to apply or take decisions when confronted with situation or event as stored in its memory. A machine is thus added intelligence by training it to process large amounts of data and make predictions on that data. The first step towards making these predictions is feeding it a large variety of data to process. When compared to human brain, it is similar to exposing the human brain to varied experiences of different situations so that a human brain can derive different conclusions and take decisions when in similar situation. If the variety of data is limited, then a human brain will obviously fail to take instant decisions when in a never-before-experienced situation. The more is the variety of data, the better is the decision-making process. A precursor to this is also identifying the variety in the data. Even subtle differences in the data add to the variety. However, care also has to be taken to understand that it is not just differences in data, but also similarities that help to categorize them into different groups. How to categorize the data depends on the problem or the situation for which decision is to be made. The whole essence of machine learning is that computers should be able to take their own decisions by applying stored knowledge and make predictions on how the data will change or how a particular event will unfold when given some specific inputs. In simple terms, for machine learning, large amount of data set is fed to a classifier, which then segregates data or processes data based on its internal algorithm or understanding, which helps it to make predictions based on which it can take informed decisions. A good classification algorithm is one where it is able to minimize errors by correctly being able to classify the data. For this, a decision boundary has to be correctly defined. To define the decision boundary, the features or characteristics of data are taken into consideration. For example, if asked to categorize a population of runners, people who practice some form of running on a regular basis, they can be categorized as those running for marathons, those sprinting, regular runners and joggers. Here, the decision boundary is the speed, frequency and distance of running. Also, there may be runners who can fall into categories of joggers as well as sprinters. So when asked to correctly determine if a particular runner is a jogger or a sprinter, the speed of running is the feature that would be used as a decision boundary. Machine learning and artificial intelligence, AI, are closely related and interchangeably used. The term machine learning was first coined by American Arthur Samuel, who was a pioneer in the field of computer science and artificial intelligence. It has evolved over the years using different areas of computational statistics, pattern recognition, mathematical optimization, computational learning, predictive analytics, and ranking algorithms. Artificial intelligence is adding intelligence to dumb machines, making them smart. This means machines would be able to carry out tasks that would make them smart. Whereas machine learning means making a machine independent enough by giving access to large amount and variety of data, such that the machine is able to learn on its own. So rather than teaching a machine fixed tasks and making it do those tasks, the machine or the computer system is exposed to huge data and trained to think or learn on its own by accessing and processing this data. There are different algorithms that are used to teach a machine to process data and learn on its own. Few applications of machine learning in day-to-day life are Google Maps giving directions to correct an erroneously taken turn while driving, Facebook giving suggestions on friends that can be added to network, LinkedIn giving suggestions on the different learning or trainings that a user can take to own his or her skills based on past job search history.